championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything. Lakers, a bit of a surprise. Happened just moments ago. The Los Angeles Lakers have claimed former Laker Avery Bradley off of waivers. Welcome back, AB. Joining me to talk about it is Ron Gutterman from LakersNation.com. Ron, big surprise. Avery Bradley back in purple and gold.
Yeah, just about everyone is back in purple and gold. If you've ever worn it once, you're welcome to do it again this year.
The theme for the offseason.
Avery Bradley's back. I'm extremely surprised. I was just saying on Twitter a couple hours ago that I thought the Lakers were for sure going into the season with 14 used roster spots. They were going to leave one open. And I guess just something about Avery Bradley being available made them want to jump on it.
Do you think this is telling in terms of the availability of some of the other Lakers? I mean, they're dealing with a number of injuries right now. THT and Ariza, we know, are going to be out for a while. Wayne Ellington, at least out for opening night. Malik Monk, Kendrick Nunn, both dealing with their fair share of injuries. That's five guys on a 14-man roster that are currently dealing with some form of injury. Now, with Nunn and Monk, we at least have some hope that they'll be able to go opening night. In fact, it sounds like Monk is probable for opening night, where Nunn is questionable. But how big a factor do you think all these injuries are in bringing in Avery Bradley?
I think it has to mean something. Look, Talen Horton-Tucker, Wayne Ellington, Kendrick Nunn, Malik Monk, if all of these guys are either not available or a little bit hobbled, you're going to need another guard. Russell Westbrook at this point in his career should not, and he can and he would, but he should not be playing 40 minutes a night or more. Mm-hmm. So you need some depth there. I also think that this has something to do with the defense we saw during the preseason. It was a topic of conversation every game that defensively it was a mess. And Avery Bradley is someone who is not only a fantastic defender in his own right, he also knows the system. He knows Frank Vogel. He knows how he coaches. And so I think that's also a part of this, where you get a guy who understands what you're trying to do defensively and actually has the tools to do it, unlike, you know, some of the other guys on the roster. And I don't want to, you know, name names or anything, but just that could be it.
Yeah, I agree. I wonder how much of this is Frank Vogel saw the defense in the preseason and went, this isn't going to work. I need somebody. And Avery Bradley has experience running the Lakers defensive system. Now, I will say he got cut by the Golden State Warriors. Preseason numbers, not that pretty. Now, it's 13 minutes per night in four games, so we're talking about a tiny sample size here for Avery Bradley, but 39% from the field, 22% from three for AB in preseason. Again, though, small sample size with the Warriors here, but the bottom line is you get a defense-first guard that you know can defend some of the higher-scoring guards in the NBA. Like, the Lakers could conceivably take Avery Bradley directly out of Warriors training camp and have him defend Steph Curry on opening night now. Like, fresh off of learning all of their plays, here you go, Avery Bradley. Go use all that against Steph.
Yeah, definitely. And he may have to tomorrow, just because, especially in the opening weeks of this season with Ellington, we don't know how long he's going to be out. We know he probably won't play tomorrow. With THT out, and if none, he's questionable right now. But if he is either not going to play or is going to play, you know, 60% healthy, Avery Bradley's a guy that knows the system and can just plug and play.
He is, and I think just having somebody who can do that, who can be that kind of ball hawk on the defensive end, that's going to be a difference maker if they do end up using him quite a bit. Remember, this is a non-guaranteed deal. The Lakers have till the beginning of January to decide whether or not they're going to keep his contract on the books. And I want to get into the contract in just a minute and talk about that as well. But let's not forget, it was a few seasons ago. We haven't seen that Avery Bradley since then. But at one point, he was arguably one of the best perimeter defenders in the NBA when he was with the Lakers in the 2019-2020 NBA season. Now, in the following season with Miami, he only played in 10 games due to injury. The season after that, only appeared in 17 games for the Houston Rockets. So this is a player who's dealt with a number of injuries in his own right. I don't know how much he has left, but the last time he wore a Lakers jersey, he was a really solid piece defensively.
Yeah, and the last time he was with the Lakers, when they won the championship, and he obviously didn't play in the playoffs, he only played in the regular season. But when he played, he was actually, if I recall, pretty good in terms of being a spot-up shooter as well. Mm-hmm. Like, he provided I think it was his second to last game as a Laker that he had like 24 points against the Clippers. Like he can do it. I'm just at this point in his career, he's a I can only do it in small bursts kind of player. I wouldn't really be giving him the reins on a nightly basis. I don't think he would play every night. This is a non-guaranteed contract, right. So possible he's not even on the team in 2 months. But I think for now, this is like a good stopgap option.
Well, and the non-guaranteed portion of the contract does help the Lakers out quite a bit here in terms of if it just doesn't work, if it doesn't fit, if they find out, hey, you know what, he just doesn't have it anymore, there's no real risk here. But I do want to talk about finances because you know what, Ron, right now, so many people are talking about the Phoenix Suns. Right. And then not being willing to give a contract to DeAndre Ayton. And then here we've been saying for a while now, over a month, we've been saying the Lakers are not going to use their 15th roster spot. Why? They're going to save it till midway through the season because they're going to save a significant amount of money. Right. A lot of money is going to be saved by the Lakers if they wait until the buyout market to use this. Instead, they got hit by injuries. And what did they do? They are spending money. They're signing Avery Bradley or they're picking up his contract, which means they're also going to be paying the luxury tax on that deal. So this is a significant expense here for the Lakers. Now, again, they could turn around and waive him in a week or so if everybody is healthy and they decide they just don't need him. But for the time being, they're using a roster spot. And if they keep him for the remainder of the season or if they keep him till the buyout market and then decide to part ways with him and bring somebody else in, this will be very, very costly for the Lakers. So I think we have to give them credit for recognizing that, you know what, we need another body. We've been hit by injuries. We need more healthy players. We need defense first guys and going and grabbing somebody.
Yeah, and look. Taylor Norton Tucker is going to be out for at least another 3 weeks, I think. Trevor Ariza is out at least another 6 or 7 mm-hmm. weeks. So that's two big losses. You're going to need depth to just absorb all those injuries. And you have Austin Reeves for that. You have Rajon Rondo for that. Now you have Avery Bradley for that. Like, you essentially have a reserve squad of guys who maybe wouldn't play at full strength, but now have a chance to prove themselves because the team just needs guards who are capable of playing at least one way, offense or defense.
And in terms of having a defensive stopper, you really lost two of them in Talen Horton-Tucker and Trevor Ariza, two guys that on the perimeter, I believe the Lakers were really counting on to be that. In fact, we know this isn't from one source. This is from two. This is from Frank Vogel and Rob Pelinka, both of them saying that they were challenging Talen Horton-Tucker to defend the other team's best perimeter player on a night-to-night basis. He's gone. Talen Horton-Tucker's out for at least a few weeks. Trevor Ariza, his versatility on the defensive end of the floor was going to be needed, and we saw how much the defense struggled during preseason. So Avery Bradley, if he's at his best, and we don't know that, but if he can tap into whatever he had with the Lakers a couple of seasons ago, is a nice fit in that regard. That said, I want to address one final thing because I know people in our chat for this video are going to be mentioning it. Why is this not James Ennis? If the Lakers were suddenly willing to spend that final roster spot, why is it not going to James Ennis and it's going to Avery Bradley instead?
You know, it's a great question. At this point, I have to believe something is horribly wrong with James Ennis. Like, I have to believe that because the amount of times it's been rumored, the amount of times we've talked about it, the amount of times he has taken social media to talk about how he should be on the Lakers.
Right.
It feels like something had to go wrong in those talks, in his workout, in his, you know, in his medical, you know, review, like in whatever physical they do. Something had to have gone wrong because it doesn't really make sense that they would just completely like move off of a player who clearly wants to play for them, fits a need, and on the surface appears healthy. I don't really get it, but I assume something had to have gone wrong.
I think there's a few things here. And first of all, I mean, they're two very different players, right? James Ennis, 6'6". He's got the ability to play on the wing. You could play him mostly at the three. Avery Bradley is 6'2". He's at his best defending ones, right? Like he's not a point guard, but the best thing he does is defend ones, sometimes twos, right? That's his thing. James Ennis is not going to do that. I would have argued that I think the Lakers needed another wing defender. James Ennis at least has the physical profile to do that. But let's face it, if both guys are at their best, James Ennis is nowhere near Avery Bradley defensively. They're not in the same tier. However, Ennis is a much better three-point shooter and floor spacer while giving you that size. I do wonder if it really just came down to we need somebody who's plug and play, and Avery Bradley is already very familiar with our defensive system, so they went there rather than Ennis just because of the fact that the season starts tomorrow.
Yeah, and I also think it's possible that they watched their six preseason games and said, look, scoring is not going to be an issue.
Right.
Turnovers are probably going to be an issue, but putting the ball in the basket is probably not going to be very hard for this team. Now, defense, this is the first time we're saying this in the Frank Vogel era. Defense is probably going to be an issue for a little while for this team. Avery Bradley does not solve anything, but he's like a small Band-Aid that you can put over the defensive issues and hope it works until Talen Horton-Tucker comes back, until Trevor Ariza comes back. Just see what you can do.
Yeah, and we'll see if he can help tide them over until those guys do come back and at least make the defense a bit more respectable. But Lakers Nation, let us know what you think. It's been a summer of returns. We've seen one Laker after another, whether it was Dwight Howard, Rajon Rondo, going farther back in time, talking about Kent Bazemore, Trevor Ariza, all these former Lakers coming back. Now add Avery Bradley to the list as well. But Lakers Nation, I want to know what you think about the Lakers using that 15th roster spot to our great surprise and using it on Avery Bradley for the time being. Fire off your thoughts in the comments down below, and don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel and ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.